Welcome to this session. I am Kirti Kapoor, Professor of English from NCERT. Today we are going to discuss some activities to assess language learning. We have spoken about ways to assess abilities, that is skills, till now. We will now consider examples of prose, poem and drama to find out what kind of oral and written questions can be formulated and what kind of activities can be done with them. To begin with, dictation. See, written and oral. So, dictation is something listening and writing combined. So, let us first understand what is dictation and why should we use it as an activity for language assessment. Dictation can also be used as a tool for assessing language competence. It is an important method of assessing the ability to speak and listen and also write. It should be different from conventional dictation. You see, once upon a time, dictation used to be given only of isolated words. We should not do that. Our dictation should be contextual. It should create meaning. Currently, dictation is not seen as a test for children's ability, but as a tool for language learning. So, it is a very good activity that can be included in the classroom process to develop language of the learners, and as teachers, we will be able to assess the learners' listening as well as writing. Dictation helps in assessing listening comprehension and writing ability, because as a teacher, you are reading a text, children are listening, comprehending and then writing. When they are writing, maybe you are assessing their spellings, etc., or you have given them some comprehension questions. So, you are assessing their writing ability and can also help draw up a plan for capacity building according to the level of the learners. So, dictation will tell you where my learners are, at which level are they learning, and accordingly you can plan activities for developing listening, speaking, reading and writing. Dictation can be used as a practice device from class 3 onwards. There must be a lot of care taken to choose paragraphs for it. Do not give words in isolation which do not create any meaning for the child. Yes, if they are along with the pictures, if they have context, it is fine. But choose small paragraphs which create a whole meaning. Then dictation becomes meaningful. You will be able to design some comprehension questions on it and children will be able to respond to it. We must choose a paragraph that is complete in itself and has meaning for children. The paragraph must be one level above the child and related to a meaningful context. So, dictation means we are trying to enhance the level of the learners. So, the level at which they are comfortable, dictation paragraph should be one level higher. By this, we will be able to assess what the child has learned subsequent to the classroom on their own. So, therefore, we are including child's self-learning aspects also into this. The whole process of giving dictation should be properly organized and done in a defined time interval. The process can be divided into the following steps. Now, let us look at the steps. Step 1. The teacher must read the selected text in even flow with proper intonation. Intonation means rising of the voice and coming down of the voice and expression at normal speed. We should not read it very fast, at a normal given speed. During this period, learners must only listen to the text being read rather than write anything. So, you are developing listening with comprehension. This will help them understand the content of the paragraph and they would be mentally prepared for it. That what next? Now, step 2. After reading in this manner, after reading the paragraph, the teacher must read the paragraph a bit slower than before so that the learner can write it easily, because you are giving them dictation. First they listen, they become familiar with the text. Okay, these type of words are going to come. This topic is about cleanliness. This topic is about swachhata. So now they are familiar with the words. So it will be easy for them to write the paragraph now. Step 3. The teacher should read aloud the paragraph slowly again. This would help children who have made mistakes or have left gaps to correct their mistakes or fill gaps on their own. Because some children write very slowly. So third time, read it very slowly, because you are giving an opportunity to the children to self-correct. So an element of self-assessment is inbuilt in this. Okay? And children who have left a few words here and there will be able to complete the paragraph. Now, each reading should be after a gap of 6 to 8 minutes. Give some time to the children to process their learning, because whatever they have listened, let them process it. Dictation of this kind helps the learner identify and correct her own mistakes. This helps her learn from her own decisions, making ability, and from her errors. So the element of assessment as learning is inbuilt in dictation. So it is a very good activity that you can take up in the classroom. The learner correcting mistakes in his or her own notebook helps the teacher get a sense of his or her level, and in that manner of all children. So therefore, dictation will tell you where all the learners are at present. And then gradually you can give, you know, activities in different directions, maybe in vocabulary, maybe in grammar in context, or other skills. The teacher should, while correcting the dictation, identify the major mistakes children are making and use them for future work plan. If children are making mistakes, for example, the words that you have given, they are not familiar with the vocabulary. Therefore, they need to be introduced vocabulary of that particular content area in different contexts, so that they become familiar with these words and are able to use them in their own context. Therefore, if we conduct a dictation properly, it would then not only help children learn, but would also help teachers assess the level of the child and develop the future plan in that context. So one assessment will tell you in which direction do I have to plan my next lesson. Now we are coming to closed test. So a paragraph. Okay. Closed test is also an activity that will help you assess the learners holistically. Okay. Let us try to understand what a closed test is. Closed test is a good way to assess proficiency in language. Yes, proficiency. If you remember, we have talked about fluency and proficiency. Fluency is at the beginner's level. Gradually, when children are introduced to various types of language examples, they start having proficiency in the language. So therefore, closed test is very good to assess the proficiency level of the learner. So this activity can be given as per the level of the child. It can be used to measure the levels of proficiency in all kinds of language abilities. In this, children are given a text with words at repeated quick intervals, deleted and blanks inserted in that place. I will explain it to you. You take a paragraph. It can be a story. It can be an anecdote. It can be a paragraph, descriptive paragraph, or a narrative paragraph. Okay? A narrative passage, descriptive passage. You take the passage. And then at a regular interval, maybe 5th, maybe 7th, maybe 9th, that is an interval. 7th, 5th, or 9th word is deleted. In place of that deletion, you put a blank. And you give that passage or that paragraph to the child to fill in the blanks. The paragraph chosen for the closed test should have a clear context and should be complete in itself. The text chosen must be interesting and challenging at the same time. The first line of the text must be retained as it is, because the first line will set the context for the entire text. And from the second line, every fifth, sixth or ninth word can be removed. The last sentence of the text is kept intact because again it will give the conclusion to the child. Each set should have at least 20 blanks so that a complete paragraph is giving meaning to the child, because children will fill in the blanks only through the meaning that they will get from the passage. Another way of choosing words to delete is deleting words of a particular category. So that is one category I have described to you. Now I will describe other categories to you. For example, you can remove only the verbs. You are testing the use of tenses over here. So you can remove only the verbs. So children will fill the appropriate verb, appropriate tense as per the context. If it is past tense, if it is a story, accordingly they will fill in the blanks with past tense. Then you can delete either the nouns or the prepositions or the adjectives could be deleted in a modified clause procedure. This will help us reduce the ability of the child about that particular component and help us form our teaching strategies. Suppose one day I have done verbs, another day preposition, then pronouns, noun and pronoun together, and then adjectives. Then probably one fine day when as a teacher I feel that children have now learnt the use of all these, I can give them a close passage where fifth or sixth or seventh or eighth word is removed and they have to fill in the blanks. Now those blanks can be anything. It can be a noun or a verb or a preposition. Then that becomes a complete proficiency test. Children must be clearly advised to first read the paragraph carefully 2 to 3 times and only then start filling the blanks. They should also be instructed to fill only one word in each blank. This test can be begun from class 3. The teacher can get the children to practice this many times and then gradually make it little difficult. Or if you want to help the learners, you can make it as an MCQ test, multiple choice test. Suppose you have removed one word. The word was R from that particular sentence. Now you give 3 options or 4 options as per the level of the learner. If it is primary, you may give 3 options only. R is was. Now as per the context, the child will pick up the word and fill in the blank. So a little bit of scaffolding is being given and gradually you can make it more difficult. There are 2 ways of marking a close test. Now assessment. The first is only those are marked as correct where the entry field matches the words in the original text. The second way is to expect words that are equivalent to the words in the original text. You see, in the original text, the word can be different and the child can write a different word. But if the meaning is clear, you should give the mark to the child. Okay? Now, an example of close test is given below. A tortoise in a pond and a fox in a nearby den were very good friends. Once they were chatting about this and that by the pond. A leopard arrived on the scene. The fox fled in panic. The tortoise, poor thing, could not move fast enough to hide or escape. I have taken only the first part of the story and the complete story is available in your materials. Now let us look at the blanks. A tortoise in a pond and a fox in a nearby den were good friends. See, I have retained the first sentence. Once they were chatting of dash and that by the pond, a dash arrived on the scene, the fox dash in panic, the tortoise poor thing dash move fast enough to hide or escape. Now let's look at the blanks. No, I will discuss this. So here the children are asked to fill in the blanks. Once the tortoise in a pond and a fox in a nearby den were good friends. Once they were chatting of this and that by the pond, a dash arrived on the scene. So in the story it was leopard. They can write tiger, That is also correct. Okay? The fox ran in panic. The tortoise, poor thing, could not move fast enough to hide or escape. So, one word, in the story it was leopard, but if the child writes tiger, there is no harm in this. So, it's child's creativity, child's imagination. So, you have to look at things in a holistic manner. Now, paragraph. Activities to assess the paragraph. Now, write the story in your own language, mother tongue or home language. This is a very good activity. Suggest a title for the story. Suppose you have given a story to the children. Now, suggest a title. So, they will go through the story once again. So, this is also a good activity to assess the learner's comprehension of that text. During this activity, the teacher must talk to the learners and ask them why they chose a particular title and which title is more appropriate. So, this type of conversation will help you assess learners. This activity is very good for language learners. Then, let us take up a poem now. I will read the poem, Special Friend. Up and down and all around, there is my shadow on the ground doing everything I do. Instead of one, he makes me two. When I run along the beach, there he is within my reach. When I build sand castles fine, there are his right next to mine. When I climb high in a tree, still he tries to follow me, but I lose him in the shade. Can it be that he is afraid? You see, reading a poem, as I told you, proper intonation, proper stress, proper expression. Now, if we give this poem to the learners, what assessment activities can be designed around it? Assessment of this poem can be done with the help of following questions. I have not given many questions here, but I have given a couple of questions. Put the tick for the correct answers. The poet's shadow forms when rain falls on him, light falls on him, it is dark, none of the above. So, light falls on him. Shadow, the concept of shadow. Now, next, he loses his shadow when he is on the beach, in the field, in the garden, in the shade. So, in the shade. So, in the shade, when there is no light, shadow cannot be there. Like this, you can ask many questions. Now, these questions can be comprehension questions. Now, these comprehension questions can be of different types. These types are true and false, match the following, and fill in the blanks, yes or no type question answers, one word answer. So, all these will help you assess the children's learning of the understanding of the poem. Now, another question that I have designed here is, what are the words used in the poem to describe what the shadow does? So, children will go back to the poem, pick up the words and bring. Now, shadow activities can be done. This is a very good activity. Here they are not sitting. You can ask them to stand up, stand next to the light from where the light is falling near the window, look at their shadow, have shadow puppets. You can ask the following questions. Do you know how shadows are formed? So, you are going across the curriculum. Shadow is formed when the light is blocked by an object. In simple words, you can tell, and you can show it as a practical also. You can take them out in the sun and then show them how shadow is being formed. You can try this side out also. Stand in front of a wall in a dark room. Ask someone to shine a torch on you. Your shadow will form on the wall. Now, use your hands to make some interesting shadow puppets. So, comprehension of the poem is done. But now we are going beyond the text. We are assessing other aspects. So, different kinds of activities can be given to assess the understanding of the learners. Now, drama. We have talked about story, we have talked about poem, and now we are going to discuss about drama. We can enact or write the script for any play or drama. It can be role play, it can be a very short one act play. It depends on the level, it depends on class that you are teaching. what grade would each learner get onto the script written by her depends upon whether what has to be expressed is emerging in the dialogues written by him or her. It depends on the topic also. We need to check if the learner is able to explain his or her ideas. So, to begin with, we give them a topic. It can be a peer activity, it can be individual activity, it can be whole class activity. The story can be converted into a drama. Okay, children can be asked to write the dialogues. So, you can assess the learners on the language skill, whether they are able to change the sentences from one form to the other form. So, lot of assessment activities can be designed for drama. Then, is she able to use words other than words already used in the original text of the drama? So, when you have asked the children to write the dialogues, are they using the same words or they have used synonyms? Are the dialogues simple, crisp and interesting? So, you are assessing the learners on these things. These can be main points for assessment for drama. Let us sum up now. We have discussed that there is a need to change the present process and the ways of assessment. We cannot assess the learners on rote memorization. For language learning, we have to connect language learning processes to the real world situation. And we have to assess on the learner's use of language in different contexts for speaking, listening, reading, writing, and within that we have to assess their vocabulary, grammar in context. So, the present system of assessment, which is a one-time assessment, which is based on only on written test, is not the right way. We have to connect assessment with teaching learning process. And within that, we have to see that assessment for learning, assessment as learning, and assessment of learning is happening. Assessment does not mean assessing only the content of the text, but requires the understanding of other areas as well. It requires appreciation and assessment of changes in understanding and development in capabilities. Okay, we need to appreciate and assess the changes. Okay, the child is now able to write one paragraph on her own. Her expression is nice. She is using proper grammar sentences. There are no errors. So, that will help us assess and create more learning situations for the students. The process of assessment must be continued throughout the session. It is continuous and can have many different stages. So, assessment for learning, assessment as learning, they are inbuilt in your teaching learning process. The assessment process should be recorded appropriately and learners should be given opportunities to learn according to the diversity is learning and background and their special requirements. So, their background has to be kept in mind. When I say connect with their background, a child coming from a background where there are a lot of